A good midday Monday to you. This weather video is driven by 802cars.com, representing 802 Toyota, Twin City Subaru, and 802 Honda, all located off of Exit 7 on Interstate 89. Good midday to you. I'm Roger Hill, weather hazards forecaster for VELCO, Weathering Heights Consulting. Let's take a look at the latest conditions. This VELCO weather hazards outlook, little to no impacts for utilities this period, but a regular workout for road crews with snow-coated roads, primary leftovers from today, that is Monday, and possibly again on Wednesday. This will be followed by yet more snow-coated roads for Thursday night into Friday morning. Snow showers and flurries possible once again on Sunday. Busy weather pattern will ensue. This will also bring generally good project weather in between each of these little bouts of precipitation. These occur on Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. The most concern for utilities will be northwesterly gradient wind gusts, and this will be relatively marginal. This will happen on Wednesday into Wednesday afternoon. Across the higher summits of the central and southern Green Mountains, the main utility concern, which is only weak. Currently, we're looking at some snowfall that's been associated with a northwesterly flow behind a departing cold front. So of note, just off to the west is this ridge of higher pressure associated 500 millibar ridge. And this will be working in for tomorrow, Tuesday, for a pretty nice day. That'll be followed by more precipitation that's upstream for Wednesday. So we have a weather system that moves in just about every other day based on the timing here. This is an area of higher pressure moving in basically late today and tonight, starting to ridge in. That'll set the stage for a fairly nice Tuesday. Also, a nice influx of warmer air aloft and its surface will make the temperatures in the 40s during the day tomorrow. That'll happen later in the day. We see a bit of what probably will be some channeling winds across the Champlain Valley. It looks like the latest indications are these will stay probably only about 35 to 40 miles per hour for high gusts. So no real utility issues there. But we do have a frontal system that moves on in. Now this will be working in during basically overnight Tuesday night and into the day on Wednesday. So this is about 12Z or about 7 o'clock in the morning Wednesday. That frontal system then swings on through, colder air follows. However, it'll have to push out the colder air, and these winds here will have to switch to west and northwesterly, and as they do, we'll have a bit of a gradient wind here with this area of higher pressure beginning to push on in. So the net effect is that area of higher pressure will then bring a pretty nice Thursday. So it's every other day. Here comes our next weather maker. This will be a frontal system. It's a little more potent, a little better chance to tap into the Gulf of Mexico, so slightly higher amounts of precipitation. This arrives Thursday night, and we get into the day on Friday. The backside of that will lower the temperature, and of course we'll end up with snow showers, so snow-coated roads once again. That area of low pressure increases as it tracks east of down east Maine, and we're in the colder air at this point, the slightly colder air. And then we get into Sunday, and that's going to be our next weather maker, where some of that precipitation begins to back into this system, as we have a little bit of blocking starting to take place a little bit to the north and east. So this system basically buckles, and that's going to happen basically along about Sunday. So yet again, some minor snow shower activity potential as well. A larger view here, kind of a quick look. These are our average mean daily high and low temperatures mixed together, our mean temperatures. Our temperature anomalies look like this. We have a major warm-up that's heading across the country in the southwestern part of the U.S. Looking at sea surface temperature anomalies, they look like that. You can see just how warm it is off the southeastern eastern coast, especially even just east of down east Maine. Look at that. It is incredibly warm. These sea surface temperatures are greater than 3.6 degrees Fahrenheit. And last but not least, this is how the jet stream looks at this moment here. A lot of jet stream energy entering the California Pacific Northwest, not so much to the eastern part of the country. This is centered on Burlington, Vermont. This is the GFS ensemble. We have rain, snow, freezing rain, ice. So keeping a kind of a color-coded idea here, mainly all snow from this morning. Then we have good weather. Next precipitation maker works in Tuesday night into the day on Wednesday. Looks like a little bit of rain on the front side. Looks like we're going to snow on the back side. Then another day looks like fairly nice on Thursday. Then we get late in the week, and beyond that, it's just a big mess, as you can see here. This is the total 7-day accumulated precipitation amounts of the QPF and melted, of course, snow and water. So most is really in parts of down east Maine over toward New Brunswick, this particular area here for the next 7 days. And we're looking at generally about a quarter of an inch here and about a half inch amount here. So further north and east you go, the more precipitation. Again, this is a very fast pattern of weather systems working in across the region. A little bit more rainy in the west and even into Southern California with some of these Pacific systems coming in ashore. Taking a look at temperature, this is the GFS Ensemble centered on Burlington, Vermont. First of all, let's call attention with this mid-block here. This is our temperatures. This is 0 degrees centigrade, freezing, above freezing, below freezing. So we're below freezing. We're going to go above freezing. This is about approximately 850 millibars, the height of Mount Mansfield or so. And that's going to happen with the warm-up we're going to see that's going to ensue. And then we're looking at a cool-down and then a warm-up, a cool-down, and so forth. These waves, this is precipitation types, are kind of a mixed bag here. And so you can kind of see the picture here. But I wouldn't trust it much past this point here. Now, in terms of what's happening on the ground, cold night tonight after a chilly day today with influx of cold air advection behind that cold front that worked through earlier on this morning. Then we're looking at temperatures to warm up to trying to make a run toward the 40s and should make it into the 40s according to the European model. And then a little bit of a cool down, but still above freezing Tuesday night. And we get into Wednesday and then a cold front that crashes. Colder weather works in, then we warm back up again and so forth. And it is a crazy weather pattern of ups and downs, and that's owed to the fact that the storm track is going to be to the north of us, and so we're seeing those temperature oscillations with warm fronts and cold fronts. Wow, take a look at this. It's almost December, but hey, it can warm up. We can see above normal temperatures. What's amazing is we're 18 degrees above normal here in the upper Midwest plains, and some of this action is going to be coming through from time to time, but look at that, 6 degrees above normal locally here across New England into the northeast United States and near neutral, just on the eastern coast of the Pacific, the west coast area, I should say. And that's it. What about 3 days later? We see a little bit of an inroad here, still relatively warmer than normal across weighted temperatures. Again, this is 3 to 7 days, and these are just maximum high temperatures only. This midday, we're seeing that area of higher pressure. This is colder than normal temperatures at freezing. So anything above that into Canada, and then you can see also in the west coast, move that over here, some of that colder weather has dropped in some parts of the interior sections of the west. That's it from here. Roger Hill, Wuthering Heights. Thanks for watching.